Hello, and welcome back to Teacher Tom's Tutorials. Hope you caught our last video there on latitude and longitude. Today, coming at you from Okemos, Michigan, in the good old U.S. of A., I think I should start off with a fashion update. I got this shirt from my friend Carlos. I'm going to tell you, he didn't get it from Okemos, Michigan, or anywhere in the good old USA, for that matter. This one, here, let me show you. Can you see that? Can you see that? I don't know. Can you see the tag? It's a Wayabetta, and it came from far... I'll show you where it came from. Here's our good old Earth there. Where did it come from? I'll tell you where it came from. It came from South America. Can you see that? And actually, I think it's from Bogota, Colombia. I hope I got that right. But that's about it for our real globe, and now we're going to go to our fine drawings of the globe. That's going to help us out in this, our social studies classroom. So, enjoy the video. All right, well, being as how this is a social studies class, I think it'd be a good idea to do some geography terms. And, in fact, maybe one of the first ones we should start with, and I know you're thinking, yes, one of the first ones we should start with is the term geography itself. Well, geography, of course, is the study of the Earth and its features. Look at that gorgeous blue marble. Isn't that just a lovely thing? Over 70% covered with water, but that's another story. So we're going to take a good look at Mother Earth there. Geographers will study the Earth's features in terms of its human characteristics and its physical characteristics. But let's knock out an Africa there and look at some aspects of the human geography. And one is to look at like a population. So as you can see up there in the northern part of Africa, there's not many people live there. It's quite sparsely populated as opposed to down there in South Africa where it's densely populated. But that's the human characteristics. Let's take a look at the physical characteristics, such as mountains. That's one feature we can look for. Or maybe we can look at a desert, like as the Sahara right there across much of northern Africa. Geographers will always also look at lakes and rivers and streams and things like that. But hey, even us geographers get hungry from time to time. So it is well known that Madagascar is known for its vanilla. So I thought I'd throw that in there. Geographers also study regions. A region, of course, is an area that shares at least one common feature. Geographers identify regions by physical features or political features, sometimes human characteristics. So there's a picture of the Middle East, and the Middle East is known for its oil, or really petroleum reserves. So that's a pretty common feature. Another term we should take a look at is exports. So let's say we want to take that oil and we're going to export it to another country. So let's just zoom it on over to India and dump off our oil. And while we're there, maybe that boat's going to pick up some TVs and we're going to bring those back to the Middle East. So now it's, of course, no longer an export to us anyway in the Middle East. That would be an import. So how about another term? Let's take a look at, what about poor Chad? What's Chad going to do? It, of course, has no direct access to the sea. And what's the term there? Of course, yep, it's landlocked. So they're going to use a plane to get their goods out of the country and to bring them back into the country. At least that's one way anyway. How about this? You got a bad country over there, and they're trying to ship some of their products over to the good old U.S. of A., and we say, whoa, stop. We're going to boycott your products because, well, there's a myriad reasons that you could decide not to trade with another country, but one of them is how they treat their people. So you could always boycott their goods if you don't want him to take them in. The goods that are moving back and forth are not goods at all. They're, in fact, people. And so when people move from one country to another, of course, that's the geographical term that we know of as migration. So maybe there's a reason for that migration. Maybe the literacy rate in one country is quite low because they don't have very many libraries versus the other. It's quite high. That's one reason for migration. What about another reason for migration? Maybe in one country the don't have very many hospitals or not very good health care, and they don't have very many schools, and so the education is poor. So what would you expect that's going to come from that country? My guess is going to have a very low life expectancy. So maybe hopping on the old SS Opportunity there to escape poor health care and few schools, maybe the people are going to move to a country that has better opportunities in health care, better opportunities in schools. And that's another reason people migrate from one country to the other. Well, short lesson today. I hope you learned a lot. I hope this helped you out. I hope this helped you visualize things. And I know you love social studies because, well, who doesn't? You know? Appreciate you coming. Thanks for stopping in. I hope to see you again soon.